Welcome everybody from the heart of hydraulics here in Lower Main, and welcome especially to our April edition of the Connected Hydraulics webinars. Today, with a little more distance like normally, we talk about predictive analytics services, and with me I have Marcello Micheli as the expert who has presented some very relevant and interesting content, I hope, for you today. Some of you may be here for the first time, so I would like to explain a little bit more again how this works. Besides from this video picture that you see, which is unfortunately very bad today, I think we have a high internet traffic, so on the provider side it's not our problem unfortunately, but it may be that the video is not so good today. Nevertheless, you will be able to see this webinar also on YouTube afterwards, and then we will see a better quality video. So from this video picture to your left, you see the content that Marcello is providing you, and I already can tell you a little bit of a secret that he has presented and prepared a live demo of the ODiN system. So I'm looking forward to do this in some minutes, and we want to do this interactive. So downwards, there's the chat section where you can put in your input, your requests, your feedback, your questions every time, and we try to make include the questions as good as possible during this webinar, but also as normal, we have presented some questions to you. So to make it a little more interactive with our participants and to get to know you a little better, I would like to start with these questions that we have prepared for you. So for the first question, please use the voting possibility to let us know of which industry sector you are coming from. If it's metallurgy, machine tools, something different. If it's something different, please use the chat area to write us the industry sector you are coming from. Okay. A lot of people from engineering, which is not an industry, I would say, but I think it's the engineering services in that example. Then we have automotive and several people coming from the metallurgy sector. Okay, all industries. Yeah, so it looks like this is the these are the services. So the second question would be then, what is your function in the company you are representing? Are you coming from maintenance, from the staff or management area? Are you from purchasing, production management, or even other areas? Okay. Various others. People from project work, salespeople, design engineer, hydraulic service, maintenance. It's a broad range, I would say, Marcello. So be prepared for various questions, I would say. And then the third and last question, do you already use condition monitoring solutions in your company right now? Okay. Quite balanced again. We had this morning session from the Asia Pacific world. It was kind of the same picture. I think even more people that are already using condition monitoring systems are kind of balanced. So yeah, thanks for this. This gave us a first good impression. So Marcello, I would say let's have a start. And I also brought a question for you. The difference between condition monitoring systems and online diagnostic services, as you call it. I think it's not everybody aware of. Maybe this is a good start for you also to present who you are and the topic itself.
Okay, Stefan, thank you for this question. It's a very good question that I'm hearing this since a lot of years every day, once, minimum once per day. But first I want to introduce me. My name is Marcello Micheli, and I'm responsible for sales and technical support for predictive analytics services. And for this we are using, you can see it on the slide, our tool ODiN, that means Online Diagnostic Network. Had nothing to do with the Scandinavian
godfather.
Godfather. Yeah. As,
but I still like the picture.
Okay. Okay. To your question, Stefan, here we can see a graphic that more or less can explain it, what it means. When condition monitoring is a good solution in the maintenance, if you want to know how is the status of your machine. Mm-hmm. And the important thing of this is the important thing of this is that you are using the same peripheral things that we are needed for our predictive analytics,
okay.
The sensors.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, but the monitoring is only to show how is the status now. It means when the red light
is activated.
Yes, thank you. Then it means that you have a problem, but
now.
You have it now. Yes,
and this is bad normally, I would say.
This is normally. This is not, nothing is wrong. Only your device is wrong, but for the situation is normally. Then we have another, not we, but exists another solution where it's possible to use some structure, some mathematical rules, and though, and though in the end you have the same situation like the first, mm-hmm. but you can predict a little bit. It means you know maybe a few hours a day earlier what can be happen.
Okay.
Yeah?
So you get an indication of a potential event.
Yes, yes. And what we are doing, or this our solution, predictive analytics, is we are reading the same values, we are reading with the same sensors, but with predictive analytics on the end, you can see more or less in a glass bowl.
Mm-hmm.
Yes? How is it can be the future? And the future is 1 or 2 weeks.
Okay.
This is the difference between condition monitoring and predictive analytics.
So I would say the difference is time to react to an, let's say, unwanted failure or
yes.
issue. Okay, thanks.
Maybe
for this.
To show it this a little bit better, only a few words of this, you can see it exactly what I mentioned before. The condition monitoring, the part is broken.
Mm-hmm.
The condition monitoring advanced. I can expect that in the next few hours something has happened. And with predictive analytics or predictive maintenance, this is the result of this, you have the optimal maintenance period where I can prepare everything.
Okay. I think thanks for this picture. There's this movie from Tom Cruise I'm thinking about. There are also some things where the police is using these things like big data analysis. I always think about this picture also.
Yes.
But I like ODiN better.
Minority Report.
A Minority Report, exactly. Okay, so I think we should go a little more into detail.
Yes, we will do this. You can see the structure, how we are doing this.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, as I said, in the first we are using sensors.
Mm-hmm.
Sensors like the condition monitoring. We collect the data, physical data with the sensors. We send it by our IoT gateway,
mm-hmm.
gateway solution
mm-hmm.
that you can see here. This is an example of this.
Okay.
We are using the IoT gateway box itself, the PLC for high frequency signals, and the analog inputs. Mm-hmm. So in this case, I can say we use analog inputs because we need analog signals, analog sensors, and not switches is not possible.
So yeah. If I stand this correct, I think here the connectivity is of issue, right? We need to understand, yeah, maybe also from the customer side. So let's put another question to our customers and participants. So the question would be to you, what connectivity solutions are available on your side right now? What are you using right now? It's a cloud or cloud-to-cloud solution, LAN via proxy, or a mobile router. Give us your impression on this, please. A lot more cloud-to-cloud than in the morning in the Asian area. Yeah. Almost well balanced between all the possibilities. Yeah. Looks like LAN and mobile router, but still also cloud to cloud. So it looks like there's a broad range of existing possibilities that you can deal with.
Yes, and this sounds good for us because we can realize all these three mm-hmm. solution. Our standard solution is the mobile router that we are using.
Okay.
With a integrated SIM card. It's pre-configured, so we send directly to the cloud. Mm-hmm. And but we offer also the possibility to connect directly from the switch to via the proxy from the customer directly to our cloud. And the last one is if customers have a own cloud, then we can connect it by cloud to cloud solution.
And this now is called the DAQ box.
This is a DAQ box. It means the data acquisition box, mm-hmm. and we have it normally in a small cabinet mm-hmm. with 56 inputs mm-hmm. Channels, but we have it also unboxed, so it's
okay.
We can use then the inputs that we need. If we need 100, then we can add this.
As you said, you're dealing with analog sensors, sensor signals. How many? What is the limit here? How much can you work with? How many signals?
With a box, maximum 56 mm-hmm. in this box, in this mm-hmm. cabinet. Without box, okay, is the normal technical range of a limitation of a PLC is 265.
So I think we will get later to the sensors again and to the sensorics, but that's good to know.
Yeah. Okay.
So following the connection, I think now it's going to the cloud.
Now the data comes to the cloud, and in the cloud are working a lot of features like big data systems, deep learning system, machine learning system, and other user interface and the one. And one of our biggest points is the cloud is our own cloud. We are the provider of this. Mm-hmm. We don't have another cloud from other providers.
Bosch, I think, no?
This is a Rexroth cloud mm-hmm. for ODiN, and this is located in Fort Knox, in Germany. This is the Bosch data center.
Okay.
Yes. So we have a lot of restriction, and so we can say this is really secure, how secure as can be.
Okay. So I think we will have some more input on the security later on, but it's good to know that it's inside Fort Knox, as you said, inside the Bosch infrastructure.
Yes, it's really important. And the second biggest point for us is this machine learning algorithm that is made by us. Mm-hmm. And the machine learning algorithm is really important because we are using this on the systems that we have to monitor or to analyze. And what I would say is when I implement ODiN on the system, then we start the learning phase. We start the learning phase to know better the functionality of this part, for mm-hmm. example, a pump. Mm-hmm. Yes, we want to know better, or ODiN want to know better the functionality. And at the same time, the information is we don't give any rules mm-hmm. to ODiN. ODiN is completely free to learn.
So it starts as a baby, completely fresh.
Yes, it's completely fresh, like a baby is don't know nothing, and the babies start to learn. More or less 4 weeks, and after these 4 weeks, we start the processing phase, mm-hmm. Where we control or analyze then that what we have learned mm-hmm. with that what we are reading now. Mm-hmm. But also, we compare this with the existing intelligence in the cloud.
Okay.
It means we have 200 systems connected and we have a collected intelligence from all these 200 systems, more or less like a child that is 16 years old, and we compare this experience.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, we compare it, and ODiN say, oh, I know it, or I don't know it. If they don't know this, then they ask us.
Okay.
We get messages, and so we can react, and on the end, we call it system behavior information, or index, or curve,
mm-hmm.
how you want, and on the end, with this information, we make a recommendation for our customer.
So it takes usually, as I said, several weeks to get this level, but then you're really up and up and running. So it's based on deep learning, you're using big data, and then you start that.
Yes.
And then, as you've shown, recommendations can start.
Yes, the recommendation is then that we say the customer, take care, something has happened. We presume regarding this, concerning this information that we have, that the pump goes broken in the next 2 weeks.
Mm-hmm.
So please plan your maintenance, plan your that what you need, and for the time and the day where we are, you can do this.
Okay.
And of course, we can support the customers depending on the contract.
Okay. So I think you call this six steps?
Yes, we call it 6 steps for happiness for every maintenance staff
so
or guy.
That's the basic system setup, but definitely relevant to know what is the setup of the customer beforehand.
Yeah.
We touched the issue of data security.
Yes.
So I think you prepared a little bit more about this. Because it's
I think everybody
is really concerned about
yes,
this.
It's a really, really critical and sensible point area, this with the connection. What we are doing here is 2 main points. We send data from the machine to the cloud.
Mm-hmm.
These data are encrypted,
mm-hmm.
and these data are only values from the sensors. We don't send machine data information, customer information, or processing information, only the value from the pressure sensor, for example. And the other important thing is we don't ask a remote access.
Okay.
Yes, we don't want go to the machine or to the plant, because sometimes that could be that we have then problem, the customer
so
has problem with the one. We have a one-way connection,
okay.
And the other security points are in the cloud. So the customer, it's not necessary that they care about security points, yes.
So
this is our thing.
And I think that's why it's so promising. Bosch is one of the leading companies in Germany, as far as I know, concerning to data security, and we are using the latest possibilities that we have. So I think that's a very, very good example here. Looking back to your 6 tips of happiness, I think a big issue, as you said, with the DAQ box was the sensorics.
Yeah.
So based also on the questions we had before, I think you also can use existing signals, right, from
yes.
the customer side,
yes, sure.
And maybe you don't know what they have. So let's place this question again to our customers and participants. What sensor signals do you already connect today? Pressure, leakage, filter and particle monitoring, or still none yet? And in the meantime, we have one question coming from, I think, internal. ODiN can be used for HD transmission. Can you HD Hägglunds drives?
I think HD means Hägglunds. The Hägglunds drives was one of our pilot projects
mm-hmm.
4 years ago, 5 years ago.
I remember Hannover
so
Fair
we
have, 3 years ago.
We have a lot of HD systems that are connected.
Okay. So let's see at the vote. Mostly pressure, and I would say oil quality, filter and particle monitoring, these are mainly
yes.
The sensor signals. Is it a typical picture that you...
Yes, it's a typical picture that we find often in older systems that we have, that there are already pressure sensors on the machine. around the motors or around the hydraulic pump and the HPU, for example. And though that's not surprised me. What we are offering is, you can see it on the slide, or what we have as sensors for our solution are, of course, for the pump, we have the pressure sensor for pump, leakage pressure sensors for the pump, and temperature. And also, really important, when we monitor the pump, we have to monitor also the electric motor. Mm-hmm. For the torque, and so we see if we have mechanical problem on the pump. So we have also current sensors for the electromotor, but on the other side from the pump also the oil cleaners.
Okay.
Means we have particle sensor, water sensor, and so on.
Okay.
For this, yes. And to your question, if there are existing sensors on the machine, mm-hmm. then can we use this also?
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay.
The only restrictions that we have to look is what kind of sensors or what kind of signals that we get.
Okay.
For example, if you want to monitor the oil and the filtration, the oil tank and so the tank level and so on, they are not so fast mm-hmm. signals. Yes, mm-hmm. a little bit slowly, so we can use it. The existing, because they are mostly connected to an existing
okay.
PLC.
Mm-hmm.
And we read it out with OPC UA.
Mm-hmm.
But OPC UA or IO-Link or other bus systems mm-hmm. are not so
okay.
fast. Yes. In this case, when we want to monitor the pump with high pressure signals, high frequency signals, then we need a direct connection between the pressure sensors and
okay.
the DAQ.
Just one question coming in from Mexico. How can I adapt the hydraulic unit to start measuring pump condition, leakage?
We measure the leakage in the drain line.
Okay.
So we are looking with it together with the temperature, and though we have with this three physical information, pressure, mm-hmm. leakage, and temperature, we know if from the hydraulic side, the pump have a problem or not.
Okay.
Together with the motor, we can see, is it mechanical?
So I hope this answered your question regards to Mexico. I think you already showed now how the system works. You showed a little bit about our DAQ, which is basically the core or the brain. Let's call it like this. The collection unit. So what is the complete package of services? Maybe you can go a little deeper in that.
Yes. What we offer to the customer are two things, two ways. This is the one-time solution.
Mm-hmm.
The one-time solution means the installation, the sensors, and the DAQ box,
mm-hmm.
and the monthly fee.
Mm-hmm.
The monthly fee, it means our monitoring assistance that we are doing for the customer. Because mostly the customers don't have the capacity and the specialists for doing this. So
okay.
we offer this for the customers. And what we're doing is a daily monitoring from
mm-hmm.
Monday to Friday. Some customers are asking, why not 24/7?
Mm-hmm.
The answer is easy to say, it's not necessary.
Okay.
Because we don't make a condition monitoring.
Okay.
Yes, we calculate
exactly.
the trend.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So if what we see today is what happens in a week. Yes,
yeah.
And so it's not so important. We make a quarterly status report for the customer. If
mm-hmm.
nothing has happened, the customer gets information from us, how is the situation of this. And if we detect something together with ODiN, yes, then we contact immediately the customer and give him our suggestions. And we contact him, we say something has happened, and we give him our idea, our recommendation, what they can do. If the customer is not so sure,
mm-hmm.
yes, because maybe he have changed something, then we go in the interaction
okay.
and we go together in the user interface, because the customer can see the same values
mm-hmm.
and data that we are seeing, and so we can discuss it and find the right
I
way.
Think it's a very, very good assumption of what you're offering. What I really like is that you also show what is not relevant and not necessary for the customers right now, and especially server, cluster, storage, security of the internet, firewall. I think these are pain issues, especially for smaller customers, so this is something we completely take care of.
Yes, it's completely technical, expensive, difficult, mm-hmm. and the scalable environment of this system is really difficult because you get a lot of information and you have to handle this. And you need specialists for this.
But still, it's all about money, I would say. Not all, but a lot. So I think you prepared a little example on the cost issue. We always have these questions on return on investment. And of course, it's very hard to say because it's depending on the system the customer is using, depending on, I would say, the amount of sensors we need. But is it easy to say once you are making one effort, one event not to occur, like one downtime, it's almost, the ROI is almost there. Is this something that you can say from your experience? When is the, when do I really get my money out of it?
It's not so easy to say it because mostly it's depending this of the size of the machine or what you are product in production. For example, you have a roller mill in the metallurgy. Mm-hmm. If a roller mill stands still,
exactly,
then you are losing 200,000 euro around this per hour.
Wow. Yeah.
Yes. Or another customer that we have, they have lost 1 million in a day.
Okay.
Yes. So in this case, you can have this return of investment really faster. Yes.
Okay.
In other case, is a little bit. You need a little bit more time. But here, what you can see is more or less medium information for this. Is a real customer. This customer is losing in a maintenance time, and that's what we see here. This 84,000 euro mentioned only the unplanned time.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, not the complete time. Only the unplanned time.
Okay.
Because they need special tools and one. So with ODiN, we reach a savement of 50% of this because he can prepare.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, he can use, for example, the Sundays.
Okay.
Yes, on the Sundays he normally don't have a production time. Mm-hmm. Yes, it's the producing, so we can use it for maintenance. And so we, with our prediction, they can plan this better.
Okay.
So save a lot of time. In this case, they invest. Returns was really fast.
Okay, so I think thanks even for bringing this because I know it's hard to provide this information on the money return, but I think this gives at least an indication, and it's fair if you say it's focusing this downtime issue. Now questions are coming in still, I think, concerning the sensorics. So let's see. A question in my case, pump leakage is related with case pressure. We have some low pressure installed in pumps, and is a good. I don't get the question, to be honest. Sometimes pump leakage is related with case pressure. We have some low pressure installed in pumps, and is a good reference. So I don't. Maybe you can rephrase your question again. Then from the Lebanon, is the catalyst program available for OEMs machines? So OEM machines.
Yes, but the catalysis system had nothing to do with the ODiN because catalysis system is an internal. I think this is maybe a colleague from a provider from us. But catalysis is a service tool that the service guys are using for repairing in a defined structure some parts,
it's a different
but
one.
Have nothing to do with the ODiN.
Okay, and then drain leakage measurement. What type of flow meter do you use to avoid causing overpressure of this critical line? Drain leakage? Is there a specific?
A drain leakage is the, I know, but I don't understand right the question.
Okay.
What type of flow meter do you use to avoid causing overpressure of this critical line? It's really critical because we are using turbines.
Mm-hmm.
But we are also using ultrasonic systems.
Okay.
So with the ultrasonics, it's you don't have problem with the overpressure.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, you
mm-hmm.
have the problem with the turbine.
Mm-hmm.
But the other side, the oversonic, are in the lowest value, not so exact.
Okay.
Yes.
And then the last question, is it necessary to install all sensors mentioned before, or the choice depend on the application, I would say?
This is a really, really good question. Please ask with us. What we don't want to do is to come with a box and full with sensors. Put it on the machine and say, okay, now is everything okay? No, we are focusing on the pain points, on the pain, on the problems directly. If the customer say, I don't have my problem on the pump, but I have problems on the cylinder, then we focus on the cylinder.
Yes. Okay.
Sometimes we monitor also the pump because that we see that the problem that comes to the cylinder comes from the pumps or for the HPU and not from the cylinders directly. Yes.
But still, thanks for your question, for your input. I think we need to proceed. I think you prepared some examples. So we have to look for the time. To all of you, I think the questions, including the documentation, will be sent out afterwards. So Marcello will make some over hours today and answer all the questions that we had, and you will resend. No, to be honest, you will get it all by email. So let's see, what kind of examples do you have for us?
Yes, I have here two examples. One of this that makes us very proud is Tata Steel in India. Mm-hmm. We have here an installation of sensors over 450 analog sensors for this, different kinds.
That's almost a capability.
Yes, but we are using here more than one.
Yeah, okay.
More than one. And we can see here different parts, and each part have one solution for this. And what we are using here, for example, if you remember in the beginning, we asked what kind of connection you have. This here is one example for the LAN connection with a proxy. And the next one is the last one, and now we are starting in the middle or end of May with the learning phase. It's Renault Tangier. Mm-hmm. Here we are monitoring the central oil power unit and the press brake press.
Okay.
Yes.
So I would say this was kind of an overview. I think you brought also a specific. Now let's maybe go into the live demo.
The live demo, yes.
There is some unit placed here in Lohr, I think in the service department, some kilometers from here.
Please tell a little story because
your connection is
your connection
is lost. Maybe doing the animatics first if it's okay.
So no, I'm here.
You have
I'm
some
here.
Time to prepare your or do you want to? So let's do the animatics and we will be back in 90 seconds so you will see a nice animation on all these potentials.
Condition monitoring with Rexroth. You want to be able to detect wear when it occurs and replace the affected components on the spot. Rexroth offers a wide range of services for identifying the extent to which components, modules, and fluids are worn. Custom tailored analyses provide information about their current state and the action which needs to be taken. Our local service specialists arrange for maintenance or repair work on a planned basis. Thus, you maximize your system uptime and reduce your total cost of ownership.
So sorry about this. This is a live situation. We just had a downtime on the direct connection, but now you are online, Marcello. So this is a system located a service system here in Bonn, but it could be everywhere.
This could be everywhere. Yes, you have how we have seen before. The examples was one
India
was in India, the other was in Morocco. Okay. We have in Philippines. This is in Lohr, and this is a test bench for our service, for a hydraulic service we are using for the valves, proportional valves. And here you can see how it looks, the user interface that you have can see also, not only we. And
the first glimpse, you already see the status?
We see the status, and we can check also what kind of sensors we can read, or we are reading. Mm-hmm. For example, you can see all these values comes in the DRQ.
I have to translate oil
the
quality.
Oil main pump, control pump, filtration tank, and so on. So and I go shortly back here and in the chart.
So you define first what kind of sensors you want to display.
Yes, we can define this, and we can choose it on this area also. So I try to don't make the mistake from.
So you are checking the last month.
We are checking the last month
for
because
a set of data.
Because the past here is really important. Because we have to see, or we can see here, when the anomaly started. Yes,
okay.
And because sometimes we get information for a short anomaly time, and then everything is again good. And in this case, we are contacting the customer because it could be that the provider on the machine have changed something.
But this here looks like a normal, there's no anomaly.
This is no anomaly, everything is okay. The system behavior information are clean, and what we see here are the signals from the behavior information of the components for oil temperature and system, complete system. The behaviors is here, the line here above.
So basically, this is the monitoring.
This is the monitoring that we are doing. Firstly, that what we've seen before with the green or red sometimes, depending. This is that what we are looking. Is if everything is okay, then we don't go deeper.
Okay.
If we get here the first information, then we look in the messages. What kind of messages the system have sending us, and then we go deeper and check this. But we have time. It's not
okay. Okay. And then in case of an anomaly, we are very quick and easy to respond. And I saw
and
also that you can translate and transfer the data, so you can very quickly send it also to the customer.
Yes.
And he can have a look at it, and in common you decide.
We contact directly by phone, by mail, by phone, mostly by phone, the customer.
The maintenance.
Or our contact in the location. And then we get the information.
Okay.
And really important is that what we see here now, this can see the customer also in the same time.
Okay, good. So looking at the time, we have 5 minutes left. I think we are almost through. We have presented a system. We have seen a little bit about the hardware. You have seen some first impression on the ODiN itself, on the monitoring solution. Obviously, there is a lot more to show, and it would cover not the time today. So this was just a start. So for further questions, I think you also have prepared an overview. We have several possibilities. So concerning overall information to ODiN, to the condition, to the analytics services, we have several areas on our website where you can find information, like to your right side, the landing page where we describe a little bit more, where you can have all the information on one page. And I especially would like to urge you to also have a look in our blog. We have the 751 blog now online since some time, and there are several contents concerning the condition monitoring and analytics issue. And if you are upon ODiN, if you are
sign in,
subscribe for this, you will receive new information. I think something's coming up, as you said.
Yes, in the next week. Said in the next 2 or 3 weeks.
Also we have on social
weekly
media,
you can find it. Yes.
And of course, if there are some questions, if you want to start some pilot projects, as you understood, I think it's very necessary for us to know your setup to make you a specific offer. So you have to go to your sales department and. Even to you, so I think even you as an expert, you're available to talk to the customer with our sales department. And I think there was one more question. I think we have some 2 more minutes. Is ODiN available to install in any country?
Is yes.
We want a global solution.
It was a global solution. Yes, it's a cloud. It's on the sky.
Okay.
And so it's reachable from everywhere. On the
I feel so relaxed. So the 6 steps of happiness and the cloud.
Yes,
in the sky.
Yes.
So I like
and
the pictures
and
you're drawing.
We have the Overgod ODiN.
And the Overgod ODiN. Yeah. Okay. That's a new marketing campaign maybe for ODiN. So if there are not any more questions, there's another one. Is the ODiN accessible to end customer, or Rexroth is taking a care about the system and Rexroth says to customer something is not working? I think that's how you described it. Basically,
yes.
The setup is
yes.
We take care about everything.
We take care about this, yes, and we say what the customer can do.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay.
Recommendation.
And then another, maybe last question, have you developed or planning to develop an API so that ODiN data can be shown on a third-party website? API is an interface,
yes,
as
yes,
you know,
yes,
I think.
No, we have it in our mind, mm-hmm. but we haven't, not yet.
Okay. Okay. Yes. And Richard, he is now several times asking us, looks like he's an internal or partner, how can I offer the customer an ODiN service? Well, he has to get in contact with you, I would say.
Contact me
obviously.
On our landing page, odin@boschrexroth.com, and then
okay,
I'm the guy behind this.
So, thanks for this. A last wish from my side. If you like this webinar, you will now get a list of questions, a list of feedback questions. But first, make sure that you don't miss the next webinar. We have a page on our website showing you the next webinar. So the next one is in about 3 weeks concerning new proportional valves. And there you also can see, if you scroll down a little, please, Marcello, the webinars we've done already that are available on YouTube, they are combined there. So if there's anything you're looking for, have a look there. And you also will find this webinar in some days over there. And now, before you leave, please give us your feedback. As I said, we will transfer the data, transfer the documentation, and the answered question to you via your registration, so you will receive it and don't miss anything. Thanks, Marcello, for your very nice presentation. Good combination of content, and looking forward to see you guys in 2.5-3 weeks. Bye-bye.
Bye.